When you're resting, you can imagine that playing these kind of thoughts and states is going to be so much more powerful for your healing than worrying about if you've overdone it, why can't you find the answer in recovery, why are things going so slow? Do you see the difference in that? Hey, warriors, it's Victoria coming to you to chat for a few minutes today about integrating all these different models of healing that we're expressing in the Academy into your recovery. And, you know, I just really want to express first my gratitude for these amazing mentors in my life. You know, I've worked with Rhea for years. Jason and I, as many of you know, were recovery buddies before he just launched into, you know, LP and into his recovery and coaching. And Claire and I go back years as well in working. She worked with me for a couple of years in, you know, listening to my emotional brain, learning to set boundaries, finding fulfillment. So, hey, Amy, awesome to see you. So, you know, I just want to share a little bit about that because for my recovery, there was not like this silver bullet, you know, and each of these mentors has had a tremendous impact in my healing. So I just want to encourage you in that. If you have tried one modality of healing and that hasn't done it for you, what I really want to say is don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. There is always something that you can glean. And so that's how I approached all of these different modalities. And, you know, it all they come back up. For instance, Ray and I worked a lot on, you know, pacing and baseline and structure. And, you know, I am using those tools every day. Those are tools for a healthy life as well. And I use them as I'm exercising and adapting myself to new forms of expansion, whether it's exercising or going out and doing things. It's all relevant. You know, the work I've done with Jason in really getting into brain retraining and hypnosis, it's just very exciting territory. I'm telling you, neuroplasticity is so on the leading edge of healing. So, and then again, I'm using boundaries and listening to my emotional brain every day. So don't ignore, like, I hope that you'll tap into each one of these mentors' message and what they're saying and kind of find which one resonates for you, but also don't discount what the other one can do for you, what their modality might mean in your life. So, you know, another thing I wanted to chat about in relation to this is I'm studying right now. I'm doing training with the Optimum Health Clinic. Some of you might be familiar with that, with Alex Howard. I've also worked a lot extensively with the Optimum Health Clinic. In the beginning, it was with their nutrition department, supplementing, you know, doing blood tests. That really helped me. I really had some serious foundational work that really helped significantly my recovery. Hey, Kathy. Yes, the different things you've done are here and there to help with your recovery. Absolutely. It's like you're working in orchestra. It's like your health is an orchestra and you're calling on different instruments at different times according to what you need. So, that is just, I think it's a great way. It's a holistic way of approaching your health. And, you know, at different times, I've been excited about different things. And like I said, for right now, I'm working on my practitioner training. I'm getting, you know, certification in clinical hypnotherapy, in neuro-linguistic programming, and in coaching. And anyway, I just love the work. So I wanted to share with you because I just had a session with some of my colleagues that are also in this training. And we were working on a tool, a process called current state, desired state. And this really is in the realm of neuroplasticity and brain retraining. But basically what you do is if you're having a challenge in something, you kind of look at your current state in that and you kind of identify what are the states. Now, a state is a way of being. You know, if you're excited or you're nervous or you're tensed up, those are different states. And then you want to look at your desired state. What would you like to be in? And I just wanted to share this with you because I'm so chilled out after this session because I was actually the client in the practice session that we did. And so I wanted to take you through a few things and just give you a personal example of this so you could begin to apply this when you're just lying in bed, recovering or doing whatever you're doing, and you have some time to think about it, because it does take a little bit of time to dip into states. And it's really good to do with a coach, but you could start this on your own and see how you go. So basically, we were looking at an issue for me that comes up when we go to a family river cabin, and how I get plexed up beforehand, and then I start getting, you know, kind of overwhelmed or plexed up, tensed up about packing, and do I have everything, and then going, and who's going to be there. It creates some challenges for me. And so what we did is we dipped into some states that I've experienced in my life. So basically the question is, what would you like differently from that? And so what I would prefer to have is I'd want to be in a relaxed state and a chilled out state. And so what we did is we went back to three different times in my life where I felt one was chilled out state, one was a no pressured state, and one was a Maui state or a beach state. And so it was funny because, you know, Jason and I are recovery buddies in the past. And so once he got his hypnotherapy certification, he sent me a few hypnotherapy sessions where he just did this hypnosis for me. And, you know, that might be kind of scary for people that have never done hypnosis, but I've done a lot of self-hypnosis in my recovery to use it to calm my nervous system down. It's an excellent way to dive in and get yourself in a relaxed healing state. And so what we did is we took myself back to when I would listen to those audios, and I would go do some laps in the pool, and then I would sit in the jacuzzi and I would listen to his audio track, and I would get so chilled out and so blissed. And I have to say, that period in my recovery was very important, listening to those tracks, dipping into a deeply relaxed, blissfully relaxed, chilled out state was really important. It was training my nervous system. So what happens is then it goes from that period that you're practicing into the rest of your life. Okay, so it overflows. So you begin, your body begins to get used to being in that relaxed state. So it's important to practice it over and over. So anyway, that was one of the states that we dipped into, was how relaxed I was. It was life is good. These were some of the descriptions that came out as I was eliciting the state. It was a green color. I had relaxation in my shoulders. I was deeply centered in my heart. I felt a sense of peace and well-being, a quiet mind. I was in awe and marveling at nature. So you can see how remembering and dipping into this is just a very relaxing practice. Then we looked at a no pressure state, and that was when, I'd like to find another word for that state, because you really want to term it in a positive frame rather than no pressure. Maybe a lightness of being would be a thing to say. And so we took myself back to when I was skiing with friends, we were on the mountain slopes, and I was thinking about the beautiful white snow, the blue sky, and feeling in my chest, it was like this bright shining light. So it's really good to give yourself a color that goes with this, because that anchors, creating an anchor in your nervous system, that this brings back that sense of well-being and peace. Saying to myself, I'm enough, I'm loved. And it was a high five energy, a high five vibe, basically, with friends and enjoying connecting with them, smiling, joyful. So that's like a little bit of hypnosis itself right there, where you're just dipping into those states. The last one was walking on the beach in Maui, being relaxed, feeling grounded and centered, a feeling of stability in my core. Acceptance and loving myself, just being, feeling myself, hearing music and seeing others on the beach enjoying themselves. Now, when you're resting, you can imagine that playing these kind of thoughts and states is going to be so much more powerful for your healing than worrying about if you've overdone it, Why can't you find the answer in recovery? Why are things going so slow? Do you see the difference in that? That eliciting these kind of states, and it's good to dip into some kind of memory, but if you don't have your own memory, just dive into mine. Use these, borrow for me. That's what people do. You get a benefit anyway just by borrowing the memory of someone else and kind of living through it and immersing your body in that. So anyway, I just got off that call and I was so chilled out and relaxed. I thought it would be fun to do a Facebook Live and share this with you because this is just another tool. It's another technique to put in your toolbox, just like all these modalities of healing, like I said, that we're sharing in the Academy. So don't give up. I just know in my recovery that went 10 years, there were so many points of frustration and hopelessness and despair, thinking literally that my life was over, that I would never get through it. But you will, and you're here in the right place where you're going to hear from mentors that are going to support your recovery. I'm so glad you're here. I just love this forum. And, you know, just like what Natalie shared, and she's almost back to factory setting. And I know she's been working on her recovery for years. And it's just so encouraging to see people kind of break through and just know that you are going to be one of those also that breaks through. So anyway, warriors, I guess that's it. It's my first Facebook Live in forever, but I did want to just check in, let you know how much I appreciate you being here. What an amazing forum I think this is. We're all focused on healing. We're all focused on, you know, finding those avenues that work for us and for well-being and peace and a great life. That's what we all want, that health and energy. And what I want to encourage you is that all of these modalities that you're learning in this forum are going to carry over into your recovered life. They're going to be assets that you're going to have for the rest of your life. So anyway, that's it. Take care, warriors. And as I always say, remember, life is not over. It's starting again. And I speak life, health, and wholeness over you.